Hello dear students, today I am going to deliver the lecture regarding the first objective of RDT. And that first objective is gene cloning. In the earlier video, I have already talked about the basic introduction of RDT, and you know very well that RDT is basically concerned with the two important areas. The one area, the very first area, is the construction of recombinant DNA, which is undergone in vitro conditions inside lab. And the second one is utilization of that rDNA, that recombinant DNA, for benefit of the society. So today, we are going to have a little bit idea of how to utilize that rDNA for the benefit of the society. Basically, there are three important objectives behind creating that recombinant DNA. The first objective, or the first way of utilizing the rDNA, is the rDNA can be utilized to obtain large number of copies of a specific DNA fragment or a specific gene, and that particular process is what is known as gene cloning. The second way of utilizing the rDNA is, once you obtain large number of copies of a specific gene, what you can do is you can recover large quantities of the protein encoded by the gene which has been cloned, and that gene which has been cloned is basically known as gene of interest or the desired gene. So what you can do, you can first multiply a gene, you can increase the number of copies of a particular gene. The process is what is known as gene cloning, and then you can produce large quantities, you can enhance the quantity of the protein which is encoded by the concerned gene. You know that DNA is what? DNA is genetic material. It is basically, it can be called as a polymer of genes, or you can say gene is a small part of DNA. That gene, what happens, that gene expresses inside cells and it makes proteins. What protein do? It execute a particular function inside cell, and because of that function, a particular character, a particular phenotype develops in the organism. So ultimately, gene is responsible for the production of proteins. Proteins are responsible for executing functions, and these functions are responsible for the development of character. So you can say that DNA, you can say that genes, they are responsible for the character of the organisms. So gene controls character. So if you have multiplied a specific gene, if you have obtained multiple copies of a specific gene of an organism by the process of gene cloning, what you can do next? You can make that gene express itself and produce the protein. Because you have multiplied the gene, the amount of protein which will be formed will be enhanced. So if you want to produce enhanced quantities of protein of a given gene, what you have to do first, you have to clone that particular gene. After cloning a gene, what you can do? You can do such an experiment to produce the large quantities of the protein, or you can also transfer that gene inside the genome of an organism. That organism is known as target organism. You can transfer your gene into the genome of an organism named as target organism, where the gene facilitates the development of a desired character in the organism concerned. So this first objective, this second objective, and this third objective, these three are the three main objectives behind the construction of rDNA. The first one is gene cloning. You will obtain large number of copies of a specific gene. Second one, once you obtained the copies, you can make them express, you can make them to produce the concerned protein. You can use that protein accordingly as per the need of the experiment, or you can use these copies of genes which you have produced by cloning for integration into the genome of an organism, so that the organism gains a desired phenotype, because you know that genes ultimately control the characters of the organism. So these three are the separate objectives of recombinant DNA technology. In this particular video, I am going through the first one, that is to obtain the large number of copies of a specific DNA fragment, which is known as gene cloning. So what is gene cloning? Gene cloning, as the name suggests, it is a process of obtaining multiple exact copies of a specific DNA fragment. Multiple exact copies. What do you mean by that, multiple exact copies? See, in the diagram, it's a short fragment of DNA which is known as a gene, and it has certain nucleotide sequence. It is having a nucleotide sequence. If we are producing the multiple copies of that gene by the process of gene cloning, what we have as a product? We have multiple number of fragments of DNA, and you note that each fragment of DNA has a sequence of nucleotides which is identical to the gene from which we begin the process. So we used that particular fragment of DNA having a particular sequence of nucleotides. We use that gene for the process of gene cloning, and what we got? We got the multiple number of exact copies of that particular gene. It means that the nucleotide sequence remains the same. So that is the meaning, the multiple exact copies. So secondly, that usually the gene to be cloned governs a useful function or character. What is the need of gene cloning? Because the gene which we select to clone which we choose to clone has some specific feature, has some specific function which is useful for the human being, or it can code to a useful character. And such type of gene is what is known as the desired gene, or it is also called as the gene of interest. So, what is basically a gene of interest? A gene whose function is desirable or which controls a useful character of an organism. That gene is known as basically the desired gene. For example, gene coding for some enzyme, some hormone in the human cell, gene having some role in milk production or secretion in cattle, gene which regulates the nutritional values, nutritional qualities of cereals or pulses. These all types of genes are desired genes because they are either they are producing some product, either they are producing some useful product, or they are controlling some useful character. So such type of genes are very valuable from the point of view of human welfare. That's why what we do, we use these genes for cloning and we produce multiple copies of those genes which can be used in further experiment. So that is the basic objective of gene cloning. So now I think that the basic meaning of gene cloning has been clear to you in your mind, that what we want, we just want to create a reservoir of a particular gene of interest which we can use in our experiment. And you know these three objectives which I have discussed earlier. If you want to achieve the second objective, if you want to achieve the third objective, it would be necessary first to accomplish the objective number one, that is gene cloning. If you will not have multiple copies of your gene, neither you will be able to produce the large quantities of the protein encoded by the concerned gene, nor you will be able to integrate that gene into the target organism so as to confer some useful character to the same. So first and very prime objective of RDT is to clone a particular gene, to clone a desired gene. So that's all for today. In successive lectures, we will go deep into each one of these three objectives. Today, I have just delivered a basic introduction of these three, along with some key concepts of the process of gene cloning. Thanks for watching. That's all about today's lecture. Thank you so much.